we're going to take out this power slider in a 2015 F-150. Traditional ways might run the risk of scratching the paint because the design on it is an exposed edge. So we're going to use Equalizer's new Raptor and our ripcord to safely remove it. These sliders are similar to the Dodge power sliders where I'm actually able to remove the cables from the slider and not have to remove the whole motor assembly. So if you're changing one and the motor is still good, you're able to disconnect it, take the slider out, and put it back in. So to remove the cables from the power slider, there are two Torx screws, one on each side. So I'm simply just going to remove those. Then there's an actual block that we just need to push back. Then we'll remove the cable on the one side. And then what we're going to do is turn the power on so I can open the slider just a little bit, give me a little bit of slack, and do the same on the other side. I've gone ahead and put a piece of tape out here to protect it, so what I'm going to do is take the loop wire starter and push it through. I want to try and come up from the corner just a little bit. So with the loop starter, we want to make sure we pull the wire that comes with it down into the groove. And now I'm going to hold both, find my spot where I want to push it through the urethane. Now when I feel it's through, I let go of the wire and I just gently back up just a little bit with the handle itself, and now I'm ready to attach the cord. Simply take the rip cord, push it through, it'll come out the bottom there for me, and I'm going to pull probably 10-12 inches. And now I'm ready to bring it on the inside. What I want to make sure I do is grab both the wire and the handle, bring it inside. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure I bring enough cord in, because I'm going to attach it on the opposite side. So I make sure I bring enough cord in that when I attach it to the Raptor, I also want to wrap around about 3 to 4 times. Now I'm going to go ahead and attach the rip cord to the Raptor by coming through the top hole. Instead of making a real knot, I just wrap it twice. Because I'm cutting in a clockwise direction, and what determines clockwise is the fact that I'm sitting inside the car and actually looking through the window that I'm cutting. So because I'm cutting in a clockwise direction, I want to wind on the tool opposite. I'm going to go ahead and wind it up. Turn on the switch. We're ready to go. And we simply go around, tuck it under, and what I'll do is just use a piece of tape so I can get to the other side. And we're going to go past where I started, and we're going to anchor over on the opposite side. But I'm not going to cut the cord just yet. So what I'm going to do is simply fold it, and what I'm going to do is go up through the anchor once, come back underneath, and go back up again. Now, that loop that we have, we're simply just going to put it right over the tab on the corners there, pull everything tight, attach the mini anchor to the glass, making sure that our tab is facing the direction that the cord's coming from. Now that I have it all laced up on the outside, I'm ready to go ahead and start cutting it out. Going slow past our connectors here, and we're just going to let the cord ride along the slider. There are wires that run along the edge of the frame on the inside of the slider underneath here. And you've got to be careful to make sure that they don't get cut or that they're attached in the urethane. And the whole time I'm cutting, I'm just keeping an eye on it. And that's the nice thing about the ripcord when working on these. We can let it ride on the slider and not have to worry about damaging the slider. Now that I'm losing my angle, what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring the cord inside, and I'm going to now make this end the anchor and my anchor end now the cutting end. So what's going to happen is it's going to cut from the driver's side, come up and across the top. Now that I have the cord brought in from the outside, I'm gonna go ahead again, make sure I have enough that I can attach the tool about 3 to 4 times. Go ahead and cut it. Now we're gonna go counterclockwise because we're coming from the other direction. So just like before, we're just gonna attach the cord to the Raptor, looping it through. And instead of making a real knot, just kind of tuck it under twice. And again, we're now cutting a different direction. So the direction that we're cutting, we're gonna wind on the tool opposite. Okay, so I'm gonna wind it on. And attach. All right. Go ahead and attach the ratchet. Start cutting. Now I haven't done anything to the other side yet. I haven't anchored the other end yet. I'm gonna start to come up the side. I wanna make sure I don't catch my defroster tab. Let's get right around that. And now we're just gonna come up the side and work our way across the top. And as we get to the top part of the slider, it's got that track. So there again, get above it. Keep an eye on, make sure we're clear of the headliner. And I'm still not feeding wire or cord yet, so that's good. So I can just continue cutting. But what I'm gonna do real quick, is before I cut any further, I'm gonna put some tape on the outside just to secure it, so that way when I make my final cuts, the window doesn't come crashing out on me. Now that we're taped up on the outside, keep cutting. Now I'm starting to lose my angle, so I'm gonna go ahead, move the Raptor down a little bit. A few seconds to draw down. Continue cutting. Now as we get to the end of the track up top here, make sure it drops down. I want to clear the headliner. Now what's happening is it's starting to feed on me. But I have so much from when I cut the bottom, I'm just going to let it feed because I'm cutting more than it's feeding. So it's kind of helping me a little bit. Now I'm going to go ahead and move the Raptor again. Bring it over here. And what I'm actually doing is I'm actually just kind of holding the other end as well. Because I have so much extra, it's actually working out quite well. I'm getting close to this defroster tab. There we go. Get over it, past it. Now, along the bottom track, make sure it's underneath. All right. Now, just for demonstration purposes, I'm gonna go ahead and show the anchor in case you're not able to hold it. So what I'm gonna do is simply just make one loop and a knot. And that loop goes up through, just like we did on the outside, only it's just once. And it's enough just to hold it in place. Again, tab facing the direction the cord's coming from. Pick up the rest of that slack. What that's gonna do is simply meet up with the anchor. It's So I've removed the slider with minimal effort, not damaging the slider or damaging the body. Also, these same techniques that I used on the F-150 can be applied to the Dodge Ram sliders as well.